With testing ramping up in the community and at areas where clusters have been located, there are some experts looking to take testing a step further to be able to identify if some people are more likely to develop complications with the virus. Kimberly Speakman has more.
From age to pre-existing health conditions and even genetics, some professors at the University of Hawaii are trying to find out why some people are more prone to having complications with COVID-19 than others.
So we've seen, even in the state, seemingly healthy individuals who might experience complication and other individuals with these risk factors that do not. So we think that this difference has to do with immune health.
About 100 people in the state who have had COVID-19 and are no longer contagious will be tested.
Pacific Islanders only account for 4% of the population, but 24% of infections of COVID-19. We do not know why, but this study is going to allow us to understand and close this gap by informing more targeted interventions in the near future.
Once the study is completed at the end of August, the new information will be shared with the Department of Health and other agencies. Dr. Scott Miskovich with Premier Medical Group, who's working on testing clusters at Kona Community Hospital and a Pearl City nursing home, says any new information on how the virus works can help them identify high-risk cases.
Somebody is going to find the answer, which if we can use, then we have a predictive value of who's going to have a problem and be in a hospital intubated, or who's just going to say, hey, go home, man, just take a Tylenol and just, you know, drink plenty of liquids and get some sleep, you're fine. That's what we're looking for.
He says this information can even be used to create a new targeted test instead of the standard PCR nasal swab test being used, and give a reason as to why some people may be experiencing blood clots and complications. Miskovich says it will take some time before studies from UH and around the nation can be applied on the field, but he and other experts will keep an eye on the developments. Kimberly Speakman, K2N2 News, working for Hawaii.
Kimberly, thank you.